So, what I am doing now for this is trying to get that equipment stuff. Not entirely sure if I appreciate how this looks. What I want to do is I want to put these right about here on the frame. I written, well, this code and then copied it over here to go ahead and make this scale out for as big as the screen is. One, two, three. So 48. With a zero-based index, one inputting a number one would get you the second item. Fortunately, here I can also do math with that kind of with that. But I could probably do it easier if I did a one-based index. Well, that didn't work. That's probably why. There we go. Yeah, I'm gonna have to do something about that though. Wait, I actually have to write code for that then. Shouldn't be too hard. Right. All right. You could tell kind of easily by observing if there's a line in the middle, but I don't know. Still kind of something you would have to look at, especially if you didn't, if you were vision impaired. Looking real closely at the screen, then you could see it. Maybe a little bit more contrast is needed. Excuse me. But for right now, I am going to not worry about it. Wait, no, not that. Make these 33. this 34. This Need to check something. Okay, so approximately, or probably exactly at pi, does it converge back to zero? So is this going to do the thing? No. What was I thinking? All right, I want to give some of these offsets. What number do I have to put there? I realized I did it here after I scrolled up. Hopefully I undid everything. And I can just copy that over here. Wait, no, that's not necessary because that will take care of that, but. You know what? I'm gonna. Copy this back over. Not there. There we go. I'm gonna put a. A character here. I'm gonna make the link to abilities host, but let's see, only include events there. Let's see, this should then work. Okay, that seems to be doing a whole lot of nothing. This is going up, but it's not swaying side. All right, I have to set that to sway side to side. I'll copy this over here. Moving down a little bit. Ah, I should have realized that that would be an issue. Oh, I do wonder why this one is not being set properly. It's because this isn't setting the Y position. Frick. Means I'm going to have to adjust by one. There. And two here. No, wait, hold on. Hold it. Okay, yeah. Wait, hold on. It's there. Okay. Okay. All right. I'm going to be the first to admit I am confused. I'm trying to get this to display properly. Did I start my timer? Yeah, I started my timer. Still not working properly. Hold on a bit. I gotta reload the resources. The only way I know how. By closing and opening a project. Should start out about 16 pixels above the bottom of the screen. Okay, a little bit above that. 14 pixels above the screen, bottom of the screen. Okay, so this gets a percentage. I multiply that percentage by the maximum amount I want this thing to stretch. So it would, be correct. It's moving it down. What? I'm just going to move this over here. Still not working quite to expectations. Sixteen 32. Because what I'm doing so far doesn't seem to work. I need to double check. Okay, 48. This should be 40. I sure just looked over here. This should be 48 out. I mean, if it was supposed to line up that way, but. Okay, so let's see. Should be 49 out. For a minute, I'm gonna delete that. Width, right? I see. Well, I may need to start one pixel up, because if you pay close enough attention, and also if the resolution is good enough, you will be able to see just a tiny little bit coming out of the corners. And I cannot have that. Seems to be charging twice as slow, but I imagine that's because this one charges in parallel. This one actually charges in series, and this one parallel, which I don't have actually linked up yet for displaying what type it is. And the other one is currently disabled, so it doesn't do anything. Maybe I can just get rid of round and that will do the trick. Maybe. First things first, though. I'm gonna change something around. And badge. Two. I don't like the glitchy stuff there. have to see what the things I set here were. 2 and 3. So 2 charges in series and 3 charges in parallel, if I remember correctly. Wrong one. Here we are. 2 charges in series. Which means I had to swap these around. No, I don't. 2, 3. Commons, playing a window. I'll be watching very closely in the bottom corner when I decide that it's close enough. There's none of that effect that I was talking about, which is a good thing, because that was an unintended effect. But I don't know. I feel like the solution isn't taking rounding off. But instead, adding rounding to yet another thing. Around the entire thing, and should be good. I should be good. So the way that this works is this goes ahead and decides the relationship between this and its predecessor. This was in series, this is in parallel. So this is in parallel with this, this is in series with this, and this is just the main one. Hey! It snaps up by the amount it needs to, and it doesn't have this slight twinkle in the corner. Which is good. Now, time to review and revise on this one. So I'm copying the first 3 digits, so times 2, 294. I want these to be offset by thirds of pi, so that way they all are not in phase with each other, but I don't want them to be in phase, because that looks like, oh yeah, okay, they share all the same thing. But if they're different, then it's like a neat effect. Alright. So charge 2, wait, hold on, I'm gonna start from the bottom, going up. Alright, so change this to 28. Alright. Next, review and change this one as necessary. So I know I gotta add a surrounding round, but round, okay, that matches up. Then characters, charge three. Okay. Now all we need to do, not have cap locks on. Round, or cap lock. Caps lock. Now let's see, does that line up as it needs to? Play in a window. This should fill up, and then I should see something happen down here. Huh. Are they charging in parallel or in series both times, or did I screw something up somewhere? I'm gonna wait for this one to fill up and see if anything happens with the next one. Something tells me I probably messed up somewhere with this one, considering that it hasn't moved. But I'm gonna double check. With first getting rid of that. But let's see. Slot 1, 2, slot 2, 3. Slot 1, 2, slot 2, 3. Okay. So if charge 1 is less than is less than 1800, this happens. If charge 1 is above 1800, or is above or equal to 1800, and charge 2 is less than 1800, this happens. Same thing, except swap charge 2 to charge 3, and this happens. So if charge 1 is at or above 1800, these two conditions may occur, but they're independent of each other to allow for one that is already ahead to charge up continuously until it hits the top, and then the other one to hit the top. Actually, I should probably do something here. I should not restrict the flow rate when one of the two is already at the top. So, two. But to make sure that charge one isn't charging, or to make sure that charge one isn't charging when that's happening. Wrong one. This will also take place. I mean, it should have worked earlier. Let's see. Oh, right, I think I deleted it. Once this reaches the top, both of them should be charging at the same time. I mean, they're both charging, but I can see I may need to make a little bit of an adjustment. Like 2 pixels over. Simple enough. I probably overestimated something. So 49. Plus 48. I guess that would make sense. Because the entire thing moves 48 pixels over, not necessarily 50. What? I don't know, but it doesn't seem to be working currently. Yeah, sorry, that was just working out weirdly in my head. It needs to be moved over 48 pixels, which 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 plus 9 is 17. Why didn't I just subtract 2 from 99? I don't know, but I didn't. Just a little bit more waiting. I do not have that key combination available, so I actually do have to wait. Oh, what fun has this been? Now I ought to do one slight different test, which is swapping the two numbers around for what equipment is currently equipped. Makes sense. I don't think I want to change this too much. You know what? I can probably do messing around with that later. Neat. Now I'll be able to see what one is like when it's charging up at a normal rate. Will these actually line up? Or at least somewhat closely? Yeah, I guess they lined up somewhat closely. And this is a. Well, it does give you the illusion that it's taking longer, but I assure you, it's taking the exact same amount of time. Alright, that was fun. I'm gonna have to copy this all the way back over to play code. Play code, play code. And I already caught something that I know I'm gonna have to change. Actually, before I do that, let me copy it from here. There we go. What is it like with multiple players? Yeah, I'm gonna have to do some modification on that. But I should be able to change this code around slightly so that it works. Now I gotta actually test it. I know this is a little bit over my requirement of exactly 1 hour. But you know, I still want to go. So, right, I'm gonna do something quick here. 2 and 3. 2 equipment.slot1. I'm gonna copy that. Paste it here. Didn't mean to open it up like that, but and I'm gonna test that out. I mean, I still have to modify this to display correctly for the type of thing, the piece of equipment there. It needs the proper badge face. Neat. I imagine you could probably abuse that somewhat for charging up the. All right, you would have to have one already charged. And then you get both a 50% charge boost. Oh no. Then again, both already are set down by a bit, so it's not like there's more flowing in, I suppose, so it's not exactly an exploit. I don't know. I'd have to test it, though. Yeah, I don't think that actually saved any time. Frick. I mean, this has been fun. I do have to set a flag for the murderer being caught because this right here should be a different thing. Play code. Variables, value of a variable. Wait, hold on. Modify a variable of an object. All right. I can see one thing wrong with this. Hold on. Character movement? No, I don't think that's it. Area name display? Character movement, light, layers, sight object, frame count, timed mode ticking, murderer visibility, area name display, sight code ordering, salt out, case display, carried item display, frame. Wait a minute, would it be a player? Copy this over here. I could probably get rid of it on this end. All right, let's see this. Will this work? Trying to give myself as many hints and thus making it a little easier when I sift through the video to confirm time stamping. Perhaps I phrased that a little weirdly. Basically, when I upload these VODs to YouTube, I usually put a time when it's recorded in the description. Right. See something? Really should not be able to. Hold on. Each object, just to double check that it's not what I think it is. I'm going to iterate. One to the iterator, and I want the ID. I'm going to copy one of these variables. Also, I should probably be catching the murderer then. Let's see. Let's fold this back up. Can get rid of that comment. Right, it's in here. When conditions. Neutral. Say code. Ability. What's in here? Nothing I can get rid of that. I got rid of that because I know that it no longer has an effect due to the fact that the variable is no longer used. Site is in collision with murderers. Murderers. Show object warning. I have no reason to believe that this will work. And it didn't. I have no reason to, but it would be reasonable to see this and think it would work. That is, I've tested this and it didn't work. But if I hadn't tested this, I would have no reason to believe it would work. All right. Area of sight is equal to murderers dot variable area. Warning is being shown. What is there like another murderer outside the map? Debugger. Objects, murder. There's one. And you know what? I'm gonna see if it has a. No. Is something up here not running? Of course it's not. No, technically they're not a case element, but it's necessary for them to be in the foyer to win, and also all the other things that are necessary to win are in the case elements variable table. I don't know if it would be quantified as a table. Maybe. Still nothing. Is there just not a thing that displays in the corner? Case display. There's just not a thing that does. When is that getting set? All right, let's see. So I have to add something here for finding a murderer. Zero, one, two, three, four, five. So it should normally be five. That is, from this. Is a. 0. Well, and this is 1. That should be 4. Right, that's just going to close. All right, hopefully now. Yep. I know what I'm going to have to do, and it's going to be some, it's going to be next stream, but it's going to be a code to communicate between, unless I already have it. Let's double check. Game state. It does not seem like I have it. So I'm going to have to go ahead and communicate the case elements, like the weapon, murderer, and characters, and the victim, to the client side. That way, I will be able to have the server manage all of these things and sync everyone up. So that way no one goes around assuming that they have found everything when the server hasn't acknowledged it. Or at least not for long anyways. If you were in chat and just didn't say anything, thank you for tuning in. I see absolutely no one in chat though, so I don't believe anyone was here today. But in any case, thank you for watching if you did. Thank you for watching on YouTube if you really felt like it for some reason.